what's pulling in. My gracious. Yeah, I can see why you're like, I'm gonna go get the car.
I love driving this thing.
Dude.
We built this in about 3 months.
Why was there a thrash? Were you getting it ready for an event or a race?
So we were going to film the daily driver race in Oklahoma, and my dad was originally gonna take my Camaro, but he's always wanted one of these ever since he was a kid. He actually had a paper route. Some guy had a 57 for sale. And I mean, he did as hard as he could to try and buy it, and they literally went to go buy it, him and my mom, and it was leaving on a trailer. So I mean, that was probably 30 years ago, and ever since then he's wanted one. So he found this one in Delaware. He went and bought it. It was a totally stock 57, running, driving.
In good shape, or did y'all have to do a whole bunch of?
It was decent. It did need a quarter panel. Someone had patched some rust at one point, but it was an all original car other than the quarter panel. And we found out that this was a factory AC car and factory E tinted glass car, which I don't know 100%, but they said that the factory AC thing was huge, and then the e-glass was kind of a rare option. But it's a 427 cubic inch LSX turbo 400 gear vendors, twin precision 76-75 mirror image, sheer fab 2000 horsepower intercooler on a Holley low ram. It still does have a vintage AC kit on it. It has ultralight brakes, titanium brakes the whole way around, CPP Hydro Boost, Mechman alternator. I mean, there's a lot done to this car, but it runs and drives so nice. You could drive this thing from here to California. It's on E85. It's got twin Holley 160 injectors in it.
Yeah, those fuel rails clearly say I mean business.
Yep.
It's awesome.
When we were building, I was even looking at it like, man, this is overkill. But the way this thing runs and drives, really can't argue it now. Fully turned up, probably make between 1,500 2,000 horsepower. I mean, for a 4,000 pound car, it boogies. Clay's been for a ride in it, so he knows.
It goes.
And
it's fun.
When he was taking people for a ride, it didn't even have the boost controller on, so it only
waste
makes 7
only,
pounds.
Yeah,
7 pounds is what it'll make.
Paddle shifted. 57
yep.
Chevrolet, paddle shifted.
Yep, there's
so cool.
No physical shifter in the car.
It's
you just
so
press park, reverse,
cool.
Neutral drive. It's pretty cool.
Nuts.
And it's not just beautiful outside. It's inside, underneath.
Yeah,
I mean, it's
all
just
factory interior, factory seat, factory dash. I did make a center console just to kind of hide the Dominator. It's got Holley Dominator system on it. Kicker stereo system. It's got 210s in the trunk. I did its steering column. It's mini tubbed. We did mini tub it to fit a 315, but we tried to make it so the rear windows even still work. I know the back end of it's dirty, but
look at the deep dish wheels. It's so cool.
RC Components did the wheels on it. And one thing that is different about this is the front is a spindle mount wheel on a stock spindle, stock 57 spindle. So that was one thing my dad was very adamant about, and as everyone knows, me and him love the spindle mount setup. It's clean, it's simple. You know, you don't have to deal with the long shank lug nuts and all that. So excess power did us a pretty good battery for it. Air motive did the fuel system. I believe this is a 5 gallon per minute or 3.5 gallon per minute in-tank pump, chisel performance, air to water intercooler box, quick performance 9-inch on it. It's still split monolith springs with sliders on it. Penske did us custom shocks for it to make the rear suspension work better. It's got Penske shocks up front, 2-inch drop ride tech spindles, ride tech upper and lower A-arms. Because like we said, my dad wants to drive this thing, you know, be able to take it anywhere. And actually, a couple weeks ago, him, my mom, and my son, we all went to a car show. So that was a lot of fun. I mean, that's kind of what the idea of the car was. Just be able to go take it to car shows, go drive it, go out with the family in it. I mean, it does make a good bit of horsepower, but it's not untreatable to where you got to work on it and all that stuff, so.
Well, this is a state of the build first. Jeffrey Lutz Jr. just said, hey, do you want to take a ride in it? Yeah, abso-freaking-lutely. Y'all, we get to go for a ride. Let's do this. Freaking awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you all for coming.
So amazing.
Like I said, we love this car. It's such a fun car and versatile car. You can just go cruise it. You can make little launches, you know. It's TLS.
It's amazing. Heavenly. But I'm so happy I got to ride in it. That was badass. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode like I did. Maybe my favorite one, because I got to actually ride in the build that we're featuring. And this was really a spontaneous episode because we're here shooting two other episodes. And you just decided to go get this car. And I was like, dude, I want to see it.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you guys so much for watching. I look forward to seeing you on the next episode. And as always, like and subscribe while you're here. If you enjoyed this episode, it means a lot to us when you do that. So we'll see y'all next time.